Don't play with me. Do not play with me. Do not talk crazy. Do not do none of that. Because I'm gonna pull up with these on. GQ, what up? It's YG, and this is my life in sneakers. I started collecting sneakers at a young age. I grew up wearing a lot of Jordans. I had Jordan everything. We used to get Jordans like every month. And the thing was, don't fuck up your Jordans. And then once they got messed up, don't throw away your Jordans. You know what I'm saying? So I feel like I was collecting shoes as a kid back in the day. But it got serious. It got real serious when I got a little older, probably like 16, 17. You know, that's when it got heavy. My luckiest shoe out of this little collection, I say, would be these right here. These are some Converse, and they special. I feel lucky because it's ASAP Nas's collab with Converse, and I ain't seen nobody with them at all. And you know, they red with the flame, with the red glittery flame. So he sent me these, and I popped the box open, and I was like, I feel lucky today. You did? Shout out to ASAP Nas, real fashion icon, you know? I've been big on Converse my whole life. Where I'm from, you feel me, that's a part of our culture. I'm still big on Converse to this day. It's part of my everyday swag. Oh, matter of fact, check him out. Converse on. The classics. You don't see nobody wearing these though. These red ones, I ain't wore yet because I've been waiting on that perfect moment, but he sent me another pair just like this. They just all black with the black shiny flame. I wore those like twice. Shout out ASAP Nas and Converse collab. Yeah, they did their thing. Most underrated, I say it's these hard bottoms. These are Saint Laurent, red patent leather. And I got them probably like, I don't know, like a year ago or something. I say they underrated, just the hard bottoms in general is because people, you know, they talk about high fashion and they talk about this and that and expensive this and expensive that. And it's like, you know, they get dressed and everybody wear the same thing and they look the same. And then they shoes be like $200 shoes or $150, $300, you know. When I come out, when I step out and I'm wearing some hard bottoms with my regular outfits, because that's what I do a lot, my shoes is at least $1,500. You know what I'm saying? So I feel like you gotta put some respect on the hard bottom game. You know what I'm talking about? When you speaking on fashion and you speaking on drip or swag, all that, you know, put some respect on the hard bottoms. You dig? And then you would see these and be like, what the f*** is YG wearing? Some Stacey Adams or some Wooty Woke? No, these are Saint Laurent, YSL. Get your s*** together. You know what I'm talking about? Get your s*** together. Yeah, I say these is my most underrated type of shoe. So my flashiest shoe out of this collection would be these. These is another pair of Saint Laurent. I call these my Michael Jacksons. You know what I'm saying? The Moonwalkers. I ain't wear these yet. I was waiting until Fashion Week 2020, but you know, everything's f***ed up, COVID-19, so I'm waiting. But don't play with me. Do not play with me. Do not talk crazy. Do not do none of that, because I'm gonna pull up with these on. You know what I'm saying? It's gonna kill the whole game. Most flashiest. What's the most unexpected? I say these right here. Louis Vuitton, red on the bottom. They ain't been worn yet due to COVID-19. Messed my plans up, but it's all good. I pick my outfits off of what event I'm going to. So if I'm about to go do like some fashion event, you know, you gotta come in there spicy. You gotta come in there unexpected. You know, so I'll probably wear this with some black leather pants, bell bottoms, custom. And then probably I do a white top. You know what I'm saying? Like a muscle shirt top, unexpected. Yeah, let the tattoo show a little bit. You feel me, the arms out. I've been doing push-ups and all that, so I'm like cut up right here. And then with the chain on top and call it a day. My most sentimental shoe, I would say would be these right here. For all the sneakerheads and the fashion people and all that. If you don't got a pair of these, I don't know if I respect your, you feel me, your whole situation, what you talk about. These are the ice creams, you know what I'm saying? If you are a fashion guy or whoever you think you is, you would know about the ice creams. Pharrell's a fashion guy, you know what I'm saying? Pharrell influenced a lot of the fashion culture from back then into now, and he's always been that dude to look at as far as when it comes to fashion and dressing and swag and music and videos and flavor and just being different, you know? Pharrell always been him. Yeah, I see everybody wearing Bapes and all that, that's cool, but if you don't got no ice creams, I do not respect your fashion game, player. Yeah, most sentimental. This right here, this shoe reminds me of, what was that? I was like 16, 17, 18 years old, you know what I'm saying, when this was out. And it was like, you feel me, if you had a pair of these, you was like, you was special, because just not anybody was wearing ice creams, you know what I'm saying? You had to be a part of that little world, that little community. So this take me back to that time, you know, when I was a young adult, a teenager, basically, and I was playing with the fashion, you feel me? That's when I first started playing with it. And, yeah, this whole movement that they had going on was like it was impactful to the culture. I forever had some ice creams sitting in the closet somewhere. These are sentimental because it takes me back to that time, you know, when I seen a young black male f***ing up the fashion world, the fashion industry, and moving the culture. And that shit is special, you dig? So, yeah. GQ, thank y'all for checking out My Life in Sneakers. I'm gonna see y'all next time. Yeah.